Hey girl, I just wanted to show you how to properly cut butternut squash because I'm a visual learner, so I thought you might be too. You need a knife. You might not be able to see me anymore. I don't know. You need a knife and that amazing vegetable peeler that I can't get enough of. Butternut squash is different. Like mine happens to be longer here and more bulbous here, but what you're looking for is that part where it indents, and just cut it right down and it's gorgeous and beautiful and I'm already excited. For this end, you want that knob gone, so just cut that off. And you can do one of two things. You can peel it like this if you want to. I think it's easier to just chop it down and then peel it like that. The seeds are usually in the bottom chamber, but if it doesn't, you know, if yours doesn't look like mine, they might be somewhere else. Doesn't really matter. But you do want them gone, so that's where all the seeds are. And then you would just take a spoon and scoop them out. And then with the actual squash, just make sure your hands are clean, and you can just hold on to it and peel it. I'm telling you, these peelers are the best thing in the world. I actually will peel it until it's the same color, this nice orange color. Sometimes when you peel it, you'll get kind of this, I don't know if you can see that, but this kind of white color, and I don't know if there's any science or if it even matters, but that's what I look for. When I'm halfway down, I'll rotate it. Peel, peel, peel. I know this is very thrilling. It's exciting stuff. That's all. And then I'm just gonna cut one to show you. Cubes, the shorter the length, the easier it is on the knife. So if you were to cut it like this, it's just not on the knife, but it's just not as easy. So I will cut it this way and just cut across. I'm looking for, I don't know, I have no idea what to measure this with. So that is still like a lot for me to cut across, so you can always just do half like that. Half, half. Okay. There. So that's done. And then you just repeat that with the rest of the squash. You want about 4 cups of squash for that soup recipe that I gave you. This is how big this one is, but this is how big this one is. It doesn't really matter. I mean, it does matter. You want it relatively consistent so that cook time is the same. Hope that was helpful. Bye.